Hey, so I am about to do a little bit of work on Book of the Damned. I haven't done very much lately. Basically, day job has been tiring and my vacation involved trying to recover from that, but I feel like working on it now, so I'm gonna work on it a bit. I have a number of sketches that I'd like to bring in today. I'll see how well I can do with getting them actually in. One sketch is Kuroki's his van here. Don't know if you can see that very well. I'm going to try to get a couple images of that. I have I'm also not sure if I'll be able to do this, but I have a sort of a plan for how one of the bedrooms is going to look that I haven't done yet. I mean, we'll sort of see where I get to. We'll also have to see, if I run into any issues, because I haven't been drawing very much lately. The tendency with all of these things is to eventually end up doing the coding instead. So maybe that'll happen as well. Let's just play through what I've got here, just so that I don't think I did a dev stream. I don't think I did dev stream based on this, so I may go through it a little bit. Let's turn down this audio a little bit. So I'm gonna real quick go through. I believe so. This doesn't require very much explanation. I may put images in here eventually. Encyclopedia. This is cultural and localization notes, which I have in the other games. This has more information related to this game. I may fill it in a little bit more today. I don't know. I introduce a calendar. So this is the date when we start. It starts on the Ides of March, and the last day is the 1st of May. And through this, we can actually skip around in the plot. Although, obviously, all the previous work, if we skip to May 1st, we're not necessarily going to get a good end because the flags for requirements are not fulfilled. I have flags for whether or not we do the opening animation. I haven't drawn anything for the opening animation yet, so there, I just really have descriptions. I have flags for adult content. I have the ability to override judgment, so this is a feature that I had planned for Manor for Amalus's actually, the protagonist is not the player character. The player character is playing themselves, or some variation of themselves, manifesting as a voice in the head of the protagonist, which kind of, in terms of narrative, kind of applies to Mana for Amalus's. But in terms of I wanted it to be a mechanical thing, and here it is in this game already. It's already a mechanical thing where we have this sort of array of options and a menu. Oh, hi, Lily. Is it still loud? I'm not really sure how OBS does. I can. Oh, that's the wrong one. Is this better? So currently the way this works is that we have a bunch of options, and they have weights that correspond to what Misato, this player character, would naturally want to do, which are in turn sometimes based on other metrics, say she plays with cats a lot, she's going to want to play with cats more. But if you give her better, if you repeatedly give her good advice, then she'll take your advice more often. But of course, that makes it hard to do like it makes it hard to play through in a deterministic way, because sometimes she won't take your advice, no matter how, until you reach like 100%, no matter how good you are about stuff, she will sometimes just ignore your advice. This option, if you turn it on, will allow you just to control her like it's a regular VN. But we can go through the game a little bit. I don't have art for the beginning scenes, in part because I have a pretty complicated plan for what I want to do for like the inside of the car, which is daunting. But I'm sort of inspired, so I may actually try that today. So here we are starting the game. The Charles Fort quote that every game starts with. And this is a modification of the bit that shows up at the beginning of Mana for Amalysis. Okay. And I guess we don't have the opening theme here, but okay. You know what? I'm gonna go back. Because we're skipping it. That's why. So, okay. I guess we don't have I guess we'd have to quit to restart. All right, but let's just keep going. So, should probably cut this. I'm not sure whether or not to cut this up here, because it's not supposed to be coherent. Writing. I want to redo this image. I fucked up the proportions pretty bad. But that was sort of the last tail end of what I had done. A few months ago. So I have Path Entrance Night. I have some plans for these two as well. Okay, here's the house, and I was thinking that I might do an even further back version of it. We have the I think we have the door image, but we don't have the door night image. So. Okay, and we have. So this compositing is actually pretty good here. I have a scene coming up a little bit later on where I want to have people back against the wall. And so I may end up having to, draw them into the scene, do a new background, instead of, having them as character sprites. But I actually think this is pretty okay. And again, like, I probably want to clean up all of these eventually. This was, both of these, I kind of want to redraw, but we'll see. I'm much better at drawing backgrounds than at drawing people. So, master, yep. And... Yep, and we don't have the house map yet. Maybe I'll do that today because it's quite straightforward. The halls are two different halls, and we have a nighttime and daytime. This is one of the first backgrounds that I drew, and so all these posters are kind of spoilers if you recognize the movies. I just traced them, really. But I think they came out pretty well. Because they're not perfect tracings. And so, you know, they have a sort of interesting... Yeah, and a fleur-de-lis pattern in the background. I want to rewrite this line here. Yeah, and there's... tarot scene coming up, and so I need to draw those. I've sort of decided to do Rider-Waite for this, and yep. So I like how well the phone came out. This looks exactly like the phone that I had in like 2008. So and we have the kitty cat scene. So, yeah, unfortunately, something is wrong with the visibility of the text sometimes here. So I have to figure out exactly what to do with that. And we have... Yep. And we have the kitty... Yep, this is a dream sequence here, and oh. What? Huh. Okay. Cat Effendi is... not defined. Okay. Well, I'll fuck around with that a little bit later. Anyway, that's like the first day sequence, and that's mostly what I've done. Scene wants to be restarted. Okay. Whatever. So actually maybe, yeah, it's, I probably will have to just redo the buttons. And that's what I did on previous games. It's normally not white text, but I think that it's generally black text, and then it's seeing that the background image is black, and so it inverts it, but doesn't recognize that actually the background image for the button is not black, the background image for the button is white. So, what I may do is, not have any fill. And in that case, it would just be a frame around the text. The thing is that that doesn't work real well with noisy backgrounds. It's one of these things. So RenPy is actually extremely straightforward, but this is one of the couple things that it doesn't do right out of the box. So like the white thing there is like the default button background, where it's white and then it's fading to transparent. And if that doesn't work with a black background out of the box, that like really sucks. Whatever. I just have to sort of deal with it. I can actually show you where that config is. May take a second, because I had to switch to Adam, and Adam is pretty heavy. Okay. Oh yeah, I didn't show you guys. I didn't show you guys this character screen. So let me show you the character screen, because I think it's interesting. I have to start the game again, and get a little bit further. And Affinity. So, we have cat affinities, and we have player affinities, and we have general affinity scores. For the protagonist sisters, Miko and Mina, they already have an affinity score. Everybody else, it has to build up. So if we go forward to where we meet. Yeah. Okay, so we don't have a Kane Affinity yet, but there's a pretty quickly we hit a point where we get Akane if... Oh. Not here yet. Okay. Where are we? Huh. I thought I gave some points earlier. Yeah, but basically when the, I could have sworn that I had given some points. Yeah, right there she ignored my, whole thing. Gosh, how do I get rid of this spam? The thing about Renpy is it's very easy to set up. Okay. Oh. So I think I screwed up names here or something. Because Cat Affinity is not filled in. Oh, well, I didn't see the cat. But Akane Affinity is not filled in here. Yeah, so it's really, really straightforward. Let me just show you, like, the March 15th that we just played through. It's like this this sort of screenplay format. So you have labels, you say scene, and then this corresponds to, like, an image. This taxi rain is an image. In fact, I can go over to... Where am I? Yeah, this is the right directory. I can go over to image and... Oh yeah, because I don't have it yet. So it just fills in with it fills in with gray and you know. So then taxi driver is the name of a character. Misato is also the name of the character, but that's actually like defined. So over here... We say define Misato equals character. That basically means that we can give her like a we can give her like a specific color of the text on the little character thing. We can give her a little like icon image that goes next to her text. We can do all sorts of other stuff. We can even, so like N here, that's narrator character. This says there's no character name, but everything is italicized. This is like the narrator character, that shows up sometimes in Mana for Amalysis. Novel narrator means that it blanks the screen and then the dialogue takes up the whole screen. So that's like what showed up for like the text at the beginning. So yeah, there's all these, and then you say show. This is just an image name. So Kuroki corresponds to this, and then I have, like, if you said show Kuroki pout, so Kuroneko is this, and you show Kuroneko pout instead, it's like that. Kuroki is the same, just, I only have the one image. We turn music on and off, so I have stop music. The normal way to do menus is straightforward, but because of the funny thing that I'm doing, I am not using that. Okay, so here's Tres Akane. That is supposed to be the Akane affinity thing. So that was supposed to be increased by one at this point. I think maybe I somehow screwed that up. Cat affinity is a different thing here. Tres Akane. Yeah, it's just that the increments are too small to actually see. So that's why that wasn't showing up. It's very, very straightforward. Let me find where I'm actually doing the perf menu. Yeah, okay, so perf menu here is my own thing that I've defined. Where have I defined it? It's that's the opening. Is it flags? Oh no, I think it's script. Script.rpy. Yeah, okay, so here's pref menu, because you can just dunk Python code into here. What pref menu does is it shows you it takes a dictionary that's like label keys to human readable description and weight. Human readable description is what shows up on the menu. The label is actually the name of the label to jump to, or I guess to call to if we select it. And then the weight is like percentage wise what Misato would normally do. It's not actually a percentage, it's just an integer. So if you give everything a weight of one, then the total is going to be, you know, the number of options, and then each one will be, you know, equally likely. But if you give everything a weight of one, then you give one thing like a weight of two, then that's going to be doubly as likely to hit. And then the player affinity is, yeah, so trust player here, that's a player affinity, and that determines, so it's if your random player affinity, okay, so player affinity biases a random coin flip, basically, and so we can select that we're going to trust the player to make that decision, or we cannot. And if we don't, then we can, you know, basically determine that we're going to do something else, or we can determine that we're not. We also have this best and worst that will sort of allow us to build up player affinity even if she doesn't take her advice. Because if we choose the worst option, regardless of whether or not she takes it, then she trusts us less. If we choose the best option, regardless of whether or not she takes it, she trusts us more. And so that's like a new thing that I wrote, but that's not how you normally do this. I just made everything more complicated for myself, really. Here's the calendar generation code. I showed you guys the calendar at the beginning. Some helper things here, so static in, static out, basically that thing where it did static before it went to a different scene, that is supposed to happen occasionally. And I have the phone label, which is you call phone, and it shows the phone and makes like this phone vibration sound, which you guys saw. It's pretty straightforward. Okay, so this is the normal way to do a menu, is you do menu tag, and then you have like these, under each option, you have these sort of sub structures. But you don't necessarily, normally you would have like a jump or a call if there's something large in here. Normally, so that's why the new pref menu thing works the way it does. I wanted to show off the dream stuff, because this is sort of complicated and interesting. So I decided that I would have a normal, or I would have an actual system for doing hints in dreams, because this is a 45-day story. And she's going to dream every night, and she's, like, a psychic. So, like, I am going to make specific dreams for specific days, but I don't want to make 45 dreams. Instead, it's even better if I generate the dreams. So, like, this is the first dream, and it will happen. In fact, you saw it. I didn't put in the images for it yet. This is another dream that happens a little bit later. I think this happens on day two. This is a dream that warns you when your cat affinity is too low, because you have to befriend the cats. But on a normal day, what will actually happen is, okay, so I have this database of dream statements. And this is, like, on subjects, so on loneliness, if you have no affinity, if you have low affinity with all the characters. Or if you have low affinity for certain characters, they're keyed by character. Low affinity with the player, low affinity with Kuroki, low affinity with cats. And these are all ambiguous statements that are primarily, like, modified quotes from other things. And so it's really oblique. But, like, if you know the characters, you may understand the reference and understand what it's trying to tell you. So, like, he speaks only Romanian, I'm very attached to him. That's a quote from Suspiria, and Akane is into Italian horror. Steak? No steak. That's a quote from Cat in the Brain, which is the very obscure Italian horror movie that Akane's shirt is the cover of, or the poster for. Radiation. Yes, indeed. That's from Repo Man. But, like, all of these are under loneliness, are just, thematic, right? Hanabi, we have, like, a line from Clue. We have, like, making fun of Sherlock Holmes, because Hanabi is, like, the cozy mystery fan. Another Clue reference. And these are like, some of these are modified to be surreal because it's supposed to be dream speech. The moon once wan is now gross. That's supposed to be Lovecraft-ish. Who else says Rugos? Only Lovecraft. So Yuko is the weird fiction fan, so her dream characters will say Root Ghost. And we have different dream characters, and so we select... The dream characters have things that they like to talk about, so depending on which dream character is selected based on these metrics, we show a different dream character. And then depending on which dream character we are showing, we will have different topics that show up. Guardian of the Dream, Hermes... and I may add more dream characters and more topics as we go on, depending on how well the dream-based hint system works. So that's my very brief... I was going to show you the logic of... I was going to show you where the color control stuff is. So it's in this file, and it's a little bit... I think it's in this file. And it's a little bit awkward. We do have control over all the colors in theory. Is it? Oh, no, it's this one. Okay, yeah, so we have font size and font color and stuff in this file. Yeah, okay, so GUI text color, interface color, idle color, and so on. I believe these ones are used for buttons by default, and then these... I may be wrong. They are. So these are the colors used for buttons. But the images that are used for buttons are... That's not it. Here. Okay, yeah, so this is what you're seeing. And that color directly matches the font color. Which is terrible, right? This is the selected version. That's like a really bad default to have, right? That's a problem. What I'd like to do is get to drawing. I want to see who's texting me. Okay. Yeah, so let's try drawing a little bit. I am going to be, I can even find the pen. I'm going to be a little bit rusty, because I haven't drawn anything in a while. But I might as well attempt the most complicated thing. Which is to do the which is to do the taxi image. So let me just try to get a sense for a reference. The image has to be from the perspective of someone sitting in the back seat. Okay. You'd think that there'd be a lot of images from the perspective of the back seat of a taxi. There are not. They're way fewer than you'd expect. Oh, why did it? View image. Okay. Oh, and this is, it's all inverted. Jeez, okay. All right. So let me, I'm just going to open a previous image of the correct size. So I think you guys had seen this. This is a picture of an audience. So I make a new transparent layer. I kill this guy. I'm gonna make another transparent layer. I will color picker, it's black, so I want to white, so now that's my white background layer. Now, so do like a windshield here, and then I will bevel the edges a little bit later, just try to get a layout here. So the counter here. Yeah, I'll also bevel this later. All right, and here we'll do the back of the headrest. Like this. Just to get a sense for steering wheel. We actually don't need that second line because it's going to be thicker. And dashboard is here. Just sketching out here. This doesn't need to be. Here's a divider. Seat divider here. Clean this up a little bit. Taxi license. And takes place in 2012, so let's have an actual tape player here. And have okay, and I can start to clean up a bit. Well, first I'm gonna do the back of this guy's head, just lay it out here. Big ass glasses there. All right. So that's good for starting layout. No longer need reference. Right. So I can start erasing this. Can better redraw this in a bit. So okay. All right. can start Bevels. I don't like the line quality in any of this. Other than the guy, actually, I think the guy looks okay. So give him that. I'll give him a shift that comes off the steering column like this. I can erase some of this. Yeah, I'm being very sketchy right now because I'm quite rusty. But I can do is I can start, if I start coloring under, I'll get cleaner forms, and then I can clear off some of the messy, sketchy outlines. Oh, you know what, before I do that, I'm going to in okay. So it's gonna taxi driver. Looking. It's a little bit higher than that. So. Give him very large. No, let's not give him very large eyes. So his glasses will warp his head out and warp. should look directly at the player. Okay. It's good enough for now. Okay. Actually, next I kind of want to do the road. So let me sketch out the street lights here. Streetlight will be like over here. These are not actually going to be easy to see. They're going to be obscured, and so it doesn't matter too much if they're a little abstract or if they kind of suck. Oh, I forgot the wipers. We need the wipers to be on. Means that wiper is too big. And I'll clean that up a little bit. Just copy this whole wiper here. down. Let's merge it down. What the heck? Here. Sorry, brain fart. Okay, so that, we have the road, we have the car. Let's do some road colors, because I want to get this working, get this looking a little less nasty. So and do like a yellow. Yeah. Kind of a sick yellow here. Oh. Actually want this under. Do a low opacity. Glow. No. Opacity is too high. So let's go down to like that, and then let's the value here. Lower the saturation somewhat. Okay. Now, here we go. So I don't know if this is coming through, but I'm giving these streetlights a little haze. What I want to do, just show it off, and this is actually going to demonstrate whether or not I've done it right, is I can make a black background here. So that looks good to me for like a night scene, right? That looks like a real streetlight glow. So now I also want to take this, make it bluer, also like browner. Okay. So what do you think? Should I go purpler, or should I go kind of greener? I'll go purpler because of the yellow. And desaturate like that. Put the value down. Okay, so that looks like a nice, ugly color, right? That looks like it's a rainy night and the street lamps are ugly and everything's ugly, which is what we want for this scene. So increase 100%. You can ugly this up. I don't know. That might be too... might be too dim. Well, we're not going to be able to see anything out the windows, really. And we can do highlights and stuff a bit. So, that's fine. And I'm being messy around the edges here because I'm going to color the car edges in a layer on top. And then I can actually redo the outlines at that stage. So I'm just gonna fill in, and I'm gonna actually do this. I'm going to color in just this street lamp because it's the closest on the next layer there. But it's going to... I'll just outline... field here. So I'll do the outline of a shape and fill the shape. I don't really need to do something that's too complex, but I will anyway because it'll make the later outlining stuff a little bit easier. And then okay. So, well, I guess this field wasn't, oh, there we go. Row one, fill, selection obviously. Yeah, GIMP has these weird default behaviors. Like, it doesn't... by default, it doesn't fill hole selection. By default, it doesn't move the active layer. Almost like the people who designed that didn't know that the way that you get any kind of reasonable behavior out of GIMP is by using layers all the time. Which I think reflects in the way that new users to GIMP don't know that you need to use layers. But as you can see, I mean, it still looks shitty, don't get me wrong, but as you will see sort of momentarily, layers are great. You can start with something shitty and then get something pretty good looking in a very short period of time if you use GIMP's layer feature in a clever way. So I like it a lot. It's interacting with the gradient edges of the brush tool now, though. So maybe I should have used the pencil tool for that, but it doesn't really matter. Now I can do my highlights. At a low opacity, bigger brush, so can do. Oh, I want this darker. Yeah, okay, that looks good. Give it a little bit of green, real dark. I don't know if any of these subtle colors are coming through for people who are watching on the stream. But basically, I'm hinting at maybe there are things in the background here that are obscured. So I'm gonna give like a... I'll do real desaturation. Kind of a brown. How about I do all the way down here? Okay, because these are gonna be like buildings. That's... too high. Okay. Maybe. Buildings alongside here. So I'm just gonna kind of make boxy structures and make them kind of in line with the structure of the street here. And that all is barely even going to come through. I like this color for the lights. So I'm going to do the lights that way. I'll do 100% for this. And just so everybody is aware that I'm gonna do I'm going to do another layer of like sort of modifying this with droplets and stuff on top of this. So, let's do that. Now, so that is too high. Capacity is too high. Hmm. general stream of... Okay, so I'm gonna have the... So the droplets are more visible when the streetlights are highlighting them. So I'm going to have this in here. You see why I decided that this was going to be daunting, right? It's not the inside of the cab that's daunting. It's the it's all the little droplets. And I was thinking if I had details, I'd make them... warp with the water droplets, but I think maybe I don't need to because it's going to be even more difficult. I'm going to make droplets warp with his glasses though, so that's a thing. Okay. The stuff that's just wiped only has little bitty droplets on it because it hasn't had time to do anything. Okay. Well, I can warp this. Amplifying it a little bit. Okay. That's okay. 12. No. 2 and then 12 for this guy. When the rain is sheeting, it's more visible because there aren't as many distinct droplets. And for a lot of this, the rain is sheeting. The opacity for some of that. Okay. Man, I had this really great idea for how cool this would look, and not really reaching it, but whatever. My drawing skills are limited. I just got to live with that. Okay, so let's do the inside of car. I figure let's do like brown leather seats. It's a dark brown leather, that's fine. So, street lights. Okay, so let's do this. This will be color for the inside of the car. Back at 100% opacity. I don't like that color. Make that darker. Okay, the contrast isn't great, but I can add some highlights later. Can add a highlight. A highlight layer. Can redo the edges a little later too. Yeah, why am I being so careful here? Okay. Well, let's just get a shape and fill it in. So the steering wheel is going to be the same color. So we might as well just do one big shape here, and then this guy is going to be all same color. Dashboard is going to be a slightly different color, and I'll probably do that as a layer underneath that, underneath this, I should say. Then like I said, I'll do the edges. I'll fix the edges in a bit. So fell. None. Okay. Yeah. Okay. How are you guys watching this, liking watching the stream of somebody who can't really draw trying to draw? Is it very exciting? Edges as I can, but I'll go back over this again with a smaller brush later, just to try to get the rest of the edges, and then I'll clean it up with the eraser in a bit too. Yeah, I'm using a Wacom. It's an older model. It's a cheaper model, and it's small. And so sometimes, if you see me like drawing, and suddenly the mouse pointer stops, that's because I've accidentally gotten to the edge of the area. Because Wacom tablets are basically, they're like a trackpad that only works with the pen, and so they have this thing where wherever you put the pen down is going to be where the mouse pointer currently is. And then wherever you move it is going to be where you move it to. Or I guess I should say it's wherever the pen comes within about an inch. And then when it's actually down, that's corresponding to clicks. So... Yeah, it's a little bit awkward though. You can sometimes see me using it to change the colors or something, but it's hard to get like all the way across the screen. And the reason is basically that in order to get the sensitivity necessary for drawing, the actual per point sensitivity is very high, but then the field is much smaller than the whole screen. So like, here's the tablet. I don't know if you can, there's a delay, so I don't know if you can actually see it. And like, here's me going all the way. Okay, let me get to the edge of the screen here. Here's me going all the way across the visual edge of the tablet, and then up and down, here's all the way up and all the way down. Whereas for some of the bigger ones, you can set it up so that it corresponds to the whole screen, especially the ones that have a screen on it. You still want your main screen because you want it bigger, and you also want to be able to see what's under your cursor. But, or even more importantly, what's under your hand. But there's a certain amount of I think if I got a newer one, which maybe eventually I'll do because I have the money now, that it would work a little bit better. This is still a little bit awkward, but it's good for drawing, but it's especially awkward for certain kinds of mouse motions where you have to go all the way across the screen. Now I'm spoiled because my usual mouse is a trackball, and so if you want to go across the screen, you can literally spin the. I mean, it didn't go because I'm holding it up, but you can spin the trackball and it'll go all, and let your thumb go and it'll go all the way across the screen. If you're using a pen, there's no momentum. And let's see here. Okay. It's good. Yeah. Okay. That's fine. I think that's fine. While I'm here, I will fix this up. That's not really, it's not a meaningful, thing, so maybe I'll obscure it a little bit. Yeah. 'Cause, we don't want people looking at this and thinking it matters. But we can use the, make it look dirty, and then that way nobody cares what it says. In fact, why don't we just that? Kind of make the. Make a suggestion of a face here. Opacity is too low here. Okay. Suggestion of a face and shoulders. There we go. So now you can't, I didn't do enough work so you can actually see who that guy is, but it looks kind of vaguely like a face. And then I can kind of do lettering where it kind of looks like there's something written. And maybe I'll get rid of these lines. Because the lines were supposed to fill in for lettering. So I get rid of those lines. Is that it? Oh. Here. So we'll get rid of the lines. as you can see, like, you sketch something out, and then if you do this, you can very, very, very quickly produce something that looks realistic, as we just did with that photo there. So what I want to do now is try to do the dash, and so gray is okay, I think. See how dark gray looks for the dash. SC back to 100%. Was 20. What do you think? Darker to go with the seats? I think that they would normally want it to kind of match the seats. So let's see, are we getting enough contrast here, though? Yeah, I think that's contrasty enough. Again, because we're going to move this underneath, it doesn't matter that I'm going over all the lines here. We can try to be a little bit cleaner here so that we don't have to erase. Okay. Okay, this is too big for the sky here, so... So, sky, and this anything? No. So, paint bucket, okay, none. So I'm missing a couple little bits here, but I'm actually liking how that looks a little bit, because the white underneath makes it look like it's shining, and that's highlights that I don't have to do. So I may keep that, but I'm also going to check to see what it looks like if I try to put black under there, and if I like that better, because I have both backgrounds. Okay. Alright. So, go with that. Now I can move this underneath. Okay. So, looks good. I'm gonna you know what? This is actually gonna be darker normally. So we'll do that, because then you get it's not that much darker. Because you have it darker, and then you have the illuminated symbols at night. So I'll do that. I'll also leave the inside of the dashboard. It's just going to be like that, where it's a little bit darker. Just a little. And then likewise. Okay, so this where that's not dark enough. Fill in like this. Okay. All right. In fact, let's do a little bit darker here. Kind of do a highlight. Alright, I like that real dark gray, so I'm gonna do that for the entertainment console here, where you can barely see any of the lines, which is good because the lines are such a mess. I can redo them as highlights in a bit. Okay. Just filling this in. I'm also going to use this color for this guy. Can use some for these. Okay. increase this a little bit. Here we are. See, now we're getting to the point where it's starting to actually look like something. Yes, kitty. Yeah, I don't know if you guys can hear the cat, but he is upset that I'm doing things other than paying attention to kitties, so he has to let me know all about it. I like the angle of that, so I'm gonna keep that like that. All right. Rounded a little more. Okay. All right. Highlight layer. It's gonna be actually. So I can use even less work, but have this sort of mottled look. Okay. Let's do bright green. Okay, it's a very expensive cab ride, and system. Okay, and I will go white for the rest of this. Okay, cool. And that looks good. The highlights. That. Okay. It's fine. It's okay. Give some highlights here to indicate this is leather. Specular highlights. And this is pretty sketchy, but I think most people who are drawing this sort of thing aren't actually going to put any of this detail in, so I think that I'm justified. 'Cause people are going to be at least a little bit impressed. I don't think that anybody is going to be under the mistaken impression that I can draw, but they're going to at least be like, oh, yeah, this guy who can't draw is sure putting a lot of effort into this. So that's all I can hope for, I think. Yeah, okay. Next is actually fill in the guy. I'm gonna give him a sallow kind of yellowy skin. I'll give him 100% opacity. This is not a highlight layer. Okay, and then he can go right under. Right under that layer. Okay. Here we go. Yeah. Opaque. That's good. Okay. Just gotta get that sheen off the pate there. Okay. Let's view. That ain't bad. You know what I didn't do is I didn't give the wheel well this color. Wheel well needs to be darker. So let's just darken the wheel well. Dark and mysterious. Let's give it like a so we can have maximum darkness actually be black or pretty close to black. Alright, that's good. Okay, I like that. So, what did we call this? It's in, Taxi Rain. Taxi Rain, okay. For it as... Now we can play and we can see if Taxi Rain looks okay. Okay, I think that looks pretty good. Okay, next up is Van Rain Splash. Yeah, I'm definitely going to redo this design here, because that looks... There's a limit to how good I can draw people, but that's exceptionally... That's out of the... out of the realm of the reasonable, I think. But probably not today. Okay... So let's now move on to so I'm going to open audience again because this gives me a nice So, I'm going to pick the color, because I've lost this color. Yeah, good. All right. I'm going to Paint bucket dump. All right. Now, add this. That is too opaque somehow. How is that too opaque? Oh. Contrast is too high. That's fine. All right. I'm going to give the van Mystery Machine colors. So it'd be all distorted by the rain. You're supposed to only vaguely be able to see what's going on here. Okay. And then do this. Thank you. Okay, that is real distorted, and that is fine. What were we calling that? We were calling that... Van Rain Splash. Save as... Let's see how that does. Path Entrance Knight and Path Knight are next. I may modify that sequence a little bit, but... But I think it's actually pretty good. At least I think the image is pretty good. So, the thing that I kind of want to do is I kind of want to do the path day and path night at the same time. Even though they'll look very different. I want them to have the same structure, so I think I'm going to do that. This is also one of these things where where I've never drawn it before, so it's probably going to be a little rough at first. Okay, actually, I think I can do this. Okay. So, just looking at a model. So, Actually, you know what? I'm not going to do outlines and fill them. I am going to just start off drawing the trees. These are too dark. Since I'm going to start with the daytime ones. Winston, hold on a sec. Gotta get the cat out.
Yeah, what are you doing?
What are you doing, little cat?
Okay. All right. And then I will... darker brown. Alright, let's get a little green here. So now I have some structure which I can use here. And I can increase opacity and then go under. So I can like this. Well, it's too much. That's too much. So I don't know if this is even going to be clear to viewers what this is. I tend towards like a sort of very abstract style, and so I feel like this is going to be clear that this is sort of a tunnel in the woods, but if some random person saw this, they know what this was? Okay. I think I'll do that. Maybe I need outlines. Hard edged. 2 pixel. 100% opacity. Black. And bring down the opacity. I don't know. Yeah, close enough for government work. Call this path entrance. Entrance night is going to be have pale blues and purples just as a highlight layer. A beam of moonlight here, and another one here. If I can actually get it to go, another one over here. So increase the opacity a little bit. Ah, it's too much. Moonlight. Okay. Model forest. And I'm gonna do bits of dew shining. Subtle. Is going to do flowers, the mushrooms that kind of look like flowers that have no chlorophyll. It's going to do some of those here, and I don't know if you guys have ever seen those, but they're very interesting looking. Okay. Then you just have the impression of the house down there. Well, it's a little bit too much. So I'll do it subtler. And do like let's give it a little bit. That's too much. 10. Right, so we'll do like that to give the impression of square. You got turrets. Turrets on top. Surreal distant. Let's give it like a pale green, so and we can give the Yeah, okay, so you're getting this sort of impression way in the background of a house. So that's not at all what I was planning for, but pretty good. And I'm going to I think I'm actually going to get rid of Path Knight here because I like that. So try that. Okay. Looks good. Okay, so let's, did I do a door image at all, other than the one we have? No, I don't. So let's open the mansion image. This is the daytime mansion. So we can get the colors right. And so that I can remind myself of what it even looks like. Okay. So column and column. column. And I want the peacocks to be about hand height, so it's the midpoint of the door, and I can do peacock on a new layer, so I do the peacock. Just check the original door design. Oh, it's not peacocks in the original door design. Okay. Here we go. I'm sorry. This is Yeah, these are actually extremely stylized pigeons. So that's, let's see, insurance having. Can I draw a circle, please? You know what, even though I need to do sun motif. In half. Well, no. This needs to look handmade. So, that is terrible. Put some pits in it. There. Nothing. Oh, that with the pencil tool. Okay. All right. Now. The reason I'm doing these sort of funny patterns here is that I'm trying to simulate the Jugendstil movement style, which love to have these patterns that were modeled on the natural world, which meant lots of curving lines and little circles. And this is a Jugendstil style, you know, replication house that is very over the top. So this is not exactly a peacock, but it's a bird that has peacock-like feathers on its back instead of its tail, which is to say it's a bird that's lekking. And so I'm doing all this greebling here, which, once we color it in, is gonna just look like interesting texture on top of the gold. And you'll get a little bit of a sense for the shapes, but you're not actually necessarily going to pay attention to a lot of the detail. And that is good, because I am too tired to actually make this detail exactly right. So, just gonna get interesting vein patterns and just like that. Yeah, I think that looks like an interesting pattern. So, let's duplicate this, and then we can flip it. Layer, flip, move this into place. Just flip this vertically and move that into place. That's good. Switch down. Switch down. All right, that looks good. And on the mock-up, I had those much higher. Yeah, okay, so I'll just have the door pattern there. Down, and I will have here. I won't do outlines for that. I was gonna do the grooves in the thing, but I won't do that. I'll do that as shadows. Okay. And color this in. Listen. Actually, I won't. We'll just... to give a sense of how thick the columns are, and then I will set 100% opacity. Okay. Won't probably this. That is too dark. Okay. It's still too dark. Okay, that's okay. Now, let's get the gold. Which I guess is just yellow in this case. Capacity 100. Okay. I'm going to go in with the eraser afterwards and clean up some of this. And then so what I'm going to do is I'm going to fill for the bird here and then flip it. Yeah, with the high contrast, the yellow there. Yeah, it's coming in real nice. Place it a little smaller. And with the gold, if we leave a little gleam, as long as it's subtle, it's not such a big deal, because gold is supposed to gleam. So, it's fine if we have little gleam. In fact, I think I may do a highlight in a little bit to put an extra bit of gleam. Good. Let's fill in the little bits of mist. Do it as a little bloom around the gold. We'll have a little low light underneath it. For texturing. Because these are three-dimensional. Okay. And naturally, the sun is also three-dimensional. That looks good to me. What do we call that? We called it door. So I'm gonna quick actually gonna do a gradient. So that's good. That's good. Okay. Let's see how this is. Okay, I think that all looks nice. I don't like how the text box tends to show up right above the most interesting parts of the image visually. But, yeah, why don't I do the house map next? So, I will open audience again, so I like to start with that. Okay, why transparency? So I will. It's gonna be too big. No, that's fine. That is fine. Okay. Mm. So this map is supposed to be pretty ad hoc, so I'm not going to try to make it look super pretty. I won't make players try to read my handwriting. It will give a fire icon. For the fireplace. So... Okay. House map. All right. I am kind of, I'm a little bit tired, so... Okay. Oh. I'm gonna have to renumber all the rooms. That's fine. That's fine. Okay. Nico will stay in room 3. Well, it's fine. And I had some kind of fix. Let's see. Another fix. I believe was port 16. You know what? I'm gonna see where it actually is. Oh. It didn't trigger that time. Getting to the second. Yeah, this is all the second day. And okay. This is mostly notes. Okay. Cool. Well, I made a lot of progress, even though it's only been a couple hours. So I'm going to call it a day here. I hope everybody has a good afternoon.